Can you see me? That's it.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
It's a great honor for me to start the oration as far as our people are concerned. And for a DGF oration, it's an opportunity for Delhi Gynecologist Forum that we have the stalwarts who have made Delhi Gynecologist Forum. I call Sangeeta one of the four pillars of Delhi Gynecologist Forum.
Thank you.
She has stood by us every day in the last 20 years. I cannot recall any event when I needed her help, she was not there. She had always given good support as far as the growth of this organization is concerned. She's a clinician par excellence. She's a great surgeon. But her quality, which many of you may not know about it, she's a great administrator. It is recognized, this administrative power and how to visualize things which are needed tomorrow are recognized by all the elders in the ESI for her, and she gives all most pan-India recommendations to them. Maternal mortality is very dear to her heart. She has been following maternal mortality for the last 12, 13 years, and every year for AOGD, she conducts maternal mortality pre-conference workshop. So I think, you know, I will not stand between you and Dr. Sangeeta as far as this oration is concerned. I'm sure she's going to unfold herself, her own oration. At the outset, congratulations to you, Sangeeta, and we are looking forward to your
wisdom. Welcome, Dr. Sangeeta. Big applause for you.
It's really my great pleasure and honor to be invited to address the audience on maternal mortality. A subject of strong concern to all of us and a subject which is quite close to my heart. At the outset, I would like to thank the organizers and Madam Sharda Jain for giving me the opportunity second time. Tumne kuch yaad dilaya ki mujhe yaad aaya. Just 10 years before, that is on 25th February 2012, I gave my first oration from the same platform on maternal mortality, lessons from the past and vision for the future. And just after approximately 10 years, I am again on the same platform to talk on the subject. Thanks a lot, madam. Thanks a lot. I bring my greetings for the mothers and mothers-to-be on this National Safe Motherhood Day celebration, that is 11th April. National Safe Motherhood Day is celebrated on 11th April next, please, every year to create awareness to adequate access to care during pregnancy, childbirth, and postnatal period. It's an initiative of the White Ribbon Alliance, and in 2003, Government of India declared 11th April as Safe Motherhood Day on the birth anniversary of Kasturba Gandhi. It became the first country to do so. We all know that India is one of the most high-risk places in the world to give birth, accounting for almost 12% of total maternal deaths globally. Every year, around 27,000 women die in India due to improper care during the pregnancy. The theme of today's celebration is stay at home during coronavirus. Keep mother and newborn safe from coronavirus. Nothing matches the experience of becoming a mother. A moment of unimaginable joy is what a mother feels when a newborn is placed on her arms. A joy every mother should have the right to experience. But for many pregnant women in India, this memory will never come to be. A moment of birth is often frightening for them. Every day, almost 808 women die due to complications of pregnancy and childbirth globally, as per the latest data available of 2017. Most of them are preventable. Every 11 seconds, a pregnant woman or a newborn die somewhere around the world. And for every woman who die, 20 to 30 encounter injuries, infection, or disabilities, some of which are really devastating. They are lifelong, they cause trauma to the family and trauma to the society and community. The cost of maternal death is very much. It's no death is like maternal death. It's tragic loss to the family, community, and nation as a whole. The consequences of orphan children and the family are many. A child, a newborn who has lost its mother is 10 times more likely to suffer from death as compared to another newborn. What is a maternal death? Maternal death is defined as death of a woman while pregnant or within 42 days of termination of pregnancy, irrespective of the duration and type of pregnancy, from any cause related to or aggravated by pregnancy or its management, but not from incidental or accidental causes. Now the question is, pregnancy is a physiological phenomenon. So many physiological phenomena are going in our body and we don't die of physiology. And what do women die of? Because pregnancy is a physiological process. Women die as a result of complications during pregnancy and childbirth. Most of these complications develop during the pregnancy and childbirth. This is a tragic reality that every woman embarking on the journey to motherhood has an increased vulnerability during pregnancy in countless ways. More prone to malnutrition, which can increase the risk of infections. A pregnancy can also exacerbate the effects of illnesses and the complications leading to maternal death can occur without warning at any time during pregnancy and childbirth. Out of all these women, we do not know which woman is going to say they'll suffer the complications, even though there is no predisposing factors. Next. How do we know that which woman will experience complications? We do not know. But this much we know, that at least 15% of all these women will experience an obstetric complication. This is as true of pregnant women in the US, Europe, as of women in Africa, Asia, and Latin America. Nobody knows why this happens, but this affects life. Most obstetric complications can neither be predicted nor prevented. But if women receive effective treatment in time, we know that almost all can be saved. Now the question arises, who are dying? The women who are most at risk. There is a concept of high risk. There is a concept of at risk. Women who are most at risk are women in rural areas, urban slums, poor households, adolescent mothers, women from minorities and tribal areas, scheduled caste and scheduled tribe groups. The ones who are dying are the women with least influence and power, the women of the rural area and rural places. Adolescent girls under the age of 15 years are at highest risk of maternal mortality. Adolescent mothers between the age of 10 to 19 face high risk of eclampsia, as we all know. They face higher risk of puerperal endometritis, systemic infections, and women aged 20 to 24 years. Child brides are less likely to receive proper medical care while pregnant or to deliver in a health facility compared to women married as adults. Next, there are certain contributory factors for the maternal mortality, like poverty, malnutrition, harmful traditional practices, illiteracy, ignorance, HIV among pregnant women. Of course, the incidence of HIV is decreasing, hence the death of mothers with HIV positivity is decreasing globally. Ineffective health services, inadequate obstetric care, inadequate essential supplies. As Madam said, water sanitation, it is a very important point for maternal health. Now, if we talk of causes of maternal mortality, 80% maternal deaths are due to direct obstetric causes and 20% are due to indirect obstetric causes. And all direct obstetric causes are preventable. That means almost 3/4 of maternal deaths are preventable, and there are four major causes of maternal death. We all know hemorrhage, infection, eclampsia, and obstructive labor. Next. Now, what is a direct obstetric death, which contributes to 75% to 80%? These are the deaths resulting from obstetric complications of the pregnant state, may it be pregnancy, labor, and puerperium, and from interventions, omissions, incorrect treatment, or from a chain of events resulting from any of the above. Hemorrhage accounts for 25% of maternal death. Unsafe abortion, 13%. Eclampsia, 12%. Obstructed labor, 8%. Infection, 15%. And others like complications of anesthesia and cesarean, give a big chunk, that is 8%. Next. Direct obstetric deaths are the deaths resulting from previous existing disease, which may be a cardiac or renal disease, malaria, anemia. We all know about anemia as a big contributory factor for maternal mortality, and that is very extensive in India. Others are hepatitis or related to chronic conditions like diabetes. Next. Hemorrhage. Next. We all know the treatment of hemorrhage, every minute counts. There is golden hour. There is a normal uneventful delivery leading to PPH, leading to acute morbidity, going to near miss and maternal death. Why? We have to predict, we have to be prepared for PPH, and we have to know how to handle PPH. Next. Preeclampsia and eclampsia. Again, I said almost 12% to 13% maternal death are due to preeclampsia and eclampsia, which is a major contributory factor. Next. Obstructed labor. The incidence of obstructed labor varies from rural to urban area. It might lead to ruptured uterus. It might lead to PPH, RVF, PVF, and maternal death. So we have to take care of obstructed labor too, and maternal sepsis, which accounts around 15% of all maternal deaths, according to WHO. As infections frequently complicate serious diseases, sepsis is final common pathway to death, both from communicable and non-communicable diseases. And as far as maternal mortality is concerned, we can say both from direct and indirect causes of maternal death, and it can be prevented by awareness, quick diagnosis, and rapid treatment of infections. We see what is the onset to death interval in the case of complications. 2 hours from PPH, 12 hours from APH, 2 days from obstructed labor, and 6 days from infection. Yes. Now, an area of great concern to all of us, unsafe abortion. More than 40% of pregnancies globally are unplanned, and 62% of these unplanned pregnancies, they end into abortions, and out of 20 million abortions are unsafe abortions. 8.9% of pregnancy-related deaths have been contributed to complications of unsafe abortion. Next. Now, as far as Indian scenario is concerned, no latest government data is available, but yes, in last 15 years, approximately 6.4 million women abort every year. 13 women in India die every day due to unsafe abortions. More than 80% women do not know that abortion is legal in India. 80 to 90% abortions are in the first trimester, and sex selection is largely an issue in second trimester. Poor, young, and unmarried are likely to delay abortion due to lack of knowledge, legality of abortion, and location of safe abortion services. This is our duty, and we have to ensure that every pregnancy is wanted and every abortion is safe. Now, what are the pathways to death? Means maternal death. We all know the three delay model. That is delay one, in deciding that there is a problem, delay two, in reaching the hospital, and delay three, in receiving the appropriate care once the patient has reached the facility. There is delay. If we talk of first delay, patient and their relatives, they do not know about the complications of pregnancy. They are not well informed about the pregnancy. They are unable to recognize that there is an emergency and we need to seek care. And even if they realize that they need to seek care, the cultural and traditional practices do not allow them to go to health facility. The second delay, patient realizes that now I have to seek health care, but she is unable to reach the facility, which may be because of out-of-reach health facilities, poor roads and communication network, poor community support mechanism. Next. Three, how a woman is transferred. They are shocking pictures, but they are really, really live pictures. But how they have been transferred, how they are being shifted to health facility once they are suffering from complications of labor and postpartum complications. Next. Third delay. Now, this is the most important delay. That is, when patient has reached the facility, reached the healthcare system, but we are not able to provide them the services because of inadequate skilled attendants, poorly motivated staff, inadequate equipment and supplies, weak referral system. Now, we know that our health facility is not able to treat the complication of the patient, but we don't have any referral system so that we can send the patient to the higher facility. System is not geared to prioritize an emergency and respond promptly. Next. As long as women died at home or on their way to hospital, the system could hide behind the excuse that women and their families were unwilling to come to healthcare facilities. But deaths of these women after they have reached the healthcare system with no or minimal delay are evidence of how the system failed them and is indeed a violation of their right to life. So to address this third delay, we have got this averting maternal death and disability program, that is AMDD, in which institutes are to provide basic and comprehensive emergency obstetric care. Next. Now comes the statistical part of maternal mortality, that how to measure the death. Maternal mortality is measured in the form of MMR, that is number of maternal deaths during a given time period per 100,000 live births during the same time period. Second part is that maternal mortality rate, number of maternal deaths in a given period per 100,000 women of reproductive age during the same time period. Next. Next is lifetime risk of maternal death. A very important health indicator of maternal health is lifetime risk of maternal health. That is the probability that a 15-year-old girl will eventually die from a maternal cause. The risk of a woman in a low-income country dying from a maternal-related cause is 130 times higher as compared to high-income country. See the difference in developing and developed countries. However, the lifetime risk is nearly half between 2000 and 2017. From 1 in 100, it has come to almost 1 in 190 globally, and there is a steep decline as far as Indian scenario is concerned. Again, a very important aspect is late maternal death. That is a death, maternal death, which has occurred after 42 days and within 1 year. And nowadays, the number of late maternal death is increasing because of availability of modern life-sustaining technologies, which enable more women to survive adverse outcome and delay some deaths beyond 42 days. Next, we see in America, almost 13.2% deaths are now late maternal deaths. Next. Now comes what is the global scenario of maternal mortality. If we compare in last two decades, there is a 38% decline in global maternal mortality ratio. That is from 342, it has come to 211. As I have discussed, that lifetime risk 1 in 100 to 1 in 190, and overall proportion of deaths in reproductive age group has significantly declined from 35.5% to 9.2%. But these data are improving not all over the world, not at all places, not for all social groups, not at the same time span. Next. In 2017, out of 295,000 maternal deaths, sub-Saharan Africa and South Asia accounted for 86% of deaths. Nigeria and India alone account for 35% global death. India contributing to 35,000 deaths yearly, that is almost 12% of global deaths. Next, there is South Asia only contributes to 5% of total maternal death, and rest of the world account only 8.5% of maternal death, with the lowest estimated count being in Australia and New Zealand. Just 26 maternal deaths in a year. In Europe, there were an estimated 740 maternal deaths. There is a significant disparity within regions, moreover within countries and inside the country. And now, next, when we talk about the India's maternal mortality, we are showing a healthy trend. In my last oration, which I took almost 10 years back, our maternal mortality ratio was 212. And now we have decreased it by 100. Now, as on latest SRS data available in 2016 and 2018, our maternal deaths ratio has come to 130. So almost 100 decline in less than last 10 years when I took the last oration. Next. There is almost a 17-point decline from the last SRS survey and the present SRS survey, saving about 2,500 mothers. Next. This is a summary of from 1938 to 2018, that in 1938, 20 per thousand, and now it is 113 per 100,000 life births. So there is a decline in maternal mortality. Next. These are again an SRS figure showing that 113 is the latest maternal mortality ratio of India. Next. Now, the states which are showing highest coronavirus infection are lowest in maternal mortality. These five states, which we see that daily so many thousands, so many lakhs patients of corona are coming, but they have done wonders as far as maternal mortality is concerned, and they have already achieved this sustainable development goal target of maternal mortality, that is less than 70 per 100,000 live births. Kerala with 43, Maharashtra with 46, Tamil Nadu with 60, Telangana with 63, and Andhra Pradesh with 65. Other states which we have reached our NHM targets are Jharkhand, Gujarat, Haryana, Karnataka, West Bengal, and Uttarakhand. And Assam, this is the state where there is maximum maternal mortality ratio. So see the difference within a country, that Kerala has 43 and Assam has 215. Such a wide disparity in maternal mortality ratio. Next. Now, talking of Millennium Development Goals and Sustainable Development Goals, Millennium Development Goals were started with the start of Millennium, that is in 2000. And at that time, it was the target that maternal mortality should reduce by 3/4 of what it was in 1990. And in that time, India's target was given as 139 maternal mortality ratio, but we miserably failed in our target and we could not reach that target. And as on today, we are having the 113 the maternal mortality ratio, but we were not able to achieve in 2015. And keeping the same thing next in mind, the main target is of sustainable development goal, which was launched in September 2015 for further 15 years. Millennium Development Goal from 2000 to 2015. Now we are talking of Sustainable Development Goal, which are from 2015 to 2030. Next. And the target for Sustainable Development Goal is ending preventable maternal mortality. As I have already told you, 3/4 of maternal mortality are preventable. And we have to reach a point where there is no maternal death which is preventable, and the global target, global maternal mortality ratio is 211 as on today, and it is supposed to be 70 by 2030. So the global target for maternal mortality ratio is 70, and every country has to reach this maternal mortality target of 70. There are certain countries who still have maternal mortality ratio more than 500, more than 600. For those countries, the sustainable development goal target has been kept nothing more than 150, 140. That is double the of the global target, and one has to work hard, because to reach the target of 70, what we have achieved in MDG, we have to decline the maternal mortality ratio 3 times more. So the target is very difficult. Next. Now, the global strategy for women, children, adolescent health, which is again from 2016 to 2030, is survive, thrive, and transform. Survive means end preventable death, both of mother and child. Thrive means ensure health and well-being. And transform means expand enabling environment. This is issued from the office of the Union Secretary General. So we have to survive, thrive, and transform ourselves. Next. Now, how can this woman's life be saved? The things which are to be done at our hand, that we have to reach those who are most at risk. We have to talk about contraception, population, stabilization services, safe and comprehensive abortion care. All births are to be attended by skilled health professionals. We have to identify barriers that limit access to quality maternal health services, like transport to appropriate services. Every pregnancy is a wanted pregnancy, and this we have to learn by heart. Next. These are certain WHO-based interventions which we all know by that by this time, that severe bleeding, oxytocin for obstructed label, we have to maintain a partogram for infection, antibiotics, so on. We have to treat the maternal causes of death. Next. Now, why in maternal mortality was able to be reduced in best? Because of the treatment of obstetric complications and treatment of infections, blood transfusions for hemorrhage, and improved obstetric care. Next. You know, we have to do this, what we have to do to save the lives of women and girls everywhere. Needless deaths of women, newborn, and children must stop. We must do more, and we must do better, because every action counts and every life counts. Next. What progress has been made in India to reduce deaths? Why there is a fall in maternal mortality ratio in India? In last 2 to 3 years, it has declined from 130 to 113. What initiatives next government has taken? Government of India has taken multiple initiatives. Next. I would thank Madam Sharda Jain for helping a lot in initiating Janani Suraksha Yojana, a Government of India initiative, a cash transfer scheme which was introduced in April 2005 with the aim of reducing maternal mortality by promoting institutional delivery among poor pregnant women. And based on the theme of Janani Suraksha Yojana, we have now Janani Shishu Suraksha Karyakram, which was introduced in 2011 with the idea of absolutely free and no expense delivery, including cesarean section, free drugs, diagnostics, blood and diet, free transport from home to institution, between facilities, and in case of a referral, and drop back to the home. Next. Birth preparedness. Now, under Janani Suraksha scheme, every mother and their relatives are told about the efficient coordination of all the activities of a pregnant woman. Next. Across the country, the JSY has resulted in health system available closer to the doorstep, high ANC registration, and high proportion of institutional deliveries. Next. Now, another Government of India initiative. In 2 2012, WHO introduced adding of adolescent health along with maternal, newborn and child health, so that until unless we focus on the health of our adolescent, we cannot reach any maternal health target. So keeping this, it was introduced RMNCH plus A in 2013. We all know many of the private clinics are also running this Pradhan Mantri Surakshit Matritva Abhiyan, that is PMSMA, which was launched in 2016 to ensure quality antenatal care and high-risk pregnancy detection in pregnant women on 9th of every month. Next. Lakshya. It is again a Government of India initiative which tells us about labor room and quality improvement initiative, which is focused and targeted approach to strengthen key processes related to the labor rooms and maternity operation theatres, which aims at improving quality of care around birth and ensuring respectful maternity care. Next. Another is that availability of comprehensive abortion care services 24/7, capacity building of medical officers in safe MTP techniques, and village health and nutrition day, which is being conducted at every Anganwadi at least once a month. Next. This is one of the latest initiatives, that is Suman initiative, that is Surakshit Matritva Ashwasan, launched in October 2019, which aims to provide assured, dignified, respectful and quality healthcare at no cost and zero tolerance for denial of services for every woman and newborn visiting the public health facility in order to end all preventable maternal and newborn deaths and morbidities and provide a positive birthing experience. Nowadays, all over world, we are focusing on positive birthing experience. The expected outcome is zero maternal mortality and newborn deaths and high quality of maternity care delivered with dignity and respect. Next. Midwifery, an area of controversy. That Government of India has initiated midwifery services in 2018 to provide access to quality maternal and neonatal health services, to promote natural birthing, to ensure respectful care and to reduce over-medicalization. It aims to create a cadre of nurse practitioners in midwifery who are skilled in accordance to ICM competencies, knowledge and capable of providing compassionate woman-centric pregnancy care. Next. We have improved the infrastructure at all the delivery points, obstetric HDU and ICU in a high case load tertiary care facilities across the country to handle complicated pregnancy, and our major hospital like Subsidium Hospital, they are well equipped with obstetric HDU and ICU and giving very good care to obstetric patients. MCH Wings sanctioned at district hospital, district women hospitals as integrated facility for providing quality obstetric and neonatal care. Next. There is upgradation and maintenance of facilities. Next. Again, we can say so many aims like projects are there all over. There is availability of 24/7 PHC. Next. Equipment availability is there at all the healthcare facility. Next. PMOC is available. Next. Now, by investing in women, children and adolescents today and over the next 15 years, we can save a generation within a generation while benefiting many more to come. But the opportunity and responsibility to act belongs to us and now. Next. We have the very important point, because all maternal deaths were not reported and clear statistical data were not available with us to know the cause of death. The maternal death surveillance and response system has been started, and all the states are reporting deaths along with its analysis for cause of death, not just the medical causes, but also some of the socioeconomic, cultural determinants, as well as the gaps in the system which contribute to the delays causing such deaths. Maternal near miss review is also being conducted at Premier Institute. Next.
Any problem?
Yeah, ma'am, there is some issue. I think the slides are not changing anymore.
There are more slides in it.
Okay.
Yes, now, yes, the RCH portal and MCTS portal, we all are aware. MCP card, that is mother and child protection card for documenting and monitoring antenatal, intranatal and postnatal care to pregnant women, immunization and growth monitoring of infant. Next. Yes, innovations. Very important aspect to deal with maternal mortality. It's not intractable. Innovation and collaboration have vital roles to play, as well as all to accelerate all our efforts to ensure that every pregnancy is safe, including in emergencies. Next. The key reason towards the lack of innovation in this area is due to no-do gap that continues to dominate our medical fraternity. As a community, there exists a fear of trying and adopting something new. This mindset needs to be broken. The entire value chain takes a moment to pause, reflect, and act on this ongoing forsaken pandemic of maternal mortality. Next. Now, we all know that oxytocin loses its efficiency as the temperature rises. So we need to develop, and we are developing, heat-stable oxytocin, preferably in the form of fast-dissolving tablets, be administered sublingually, carbetocin room temperature stable is such an initiative. Next. In low resource settings, uterine balloon tamponade is an effective method of addressing uncontrolled PTH from uterine attorney. However, UBT devices are often not affordable and available. Every second matters, UBT device, Chhattisgarh UBT device, etc. should be made available easily. Next. There is a need to develop blood pressure monitors to be used by healthcare workers that can exhibit danger zones, both of low blood pressure and high blood pressure, by a color coding system. A semi-automated device for detection of hypertension and shock from obstetric hemorrhage and sepsis. Next. A safe, acceptable, affordable, simple flow control pump should be made available for the easy delivery of magnesium sulfate to be used by health workers. I remember my days of Lady Harding in 1986 when Madam Sharda Jain, she taught us from A to Z of magnesium sulfate therapy. And from that day to till date, we cannot forget the doses of magnesium sulfate and how to give magnesium sulfate. So the utility of magnesium sulfate cannot be ignored, and it has to be made available by giving in periphery. Provision of cardiorespiratory support for pulmonary catastrophe should be there. Now, a very important topic, and I think we all should be aware of it, is synthetic blood. Blood cannot be made available in peripheral and rural areas due to its cross-matching, long-term storage availability and compatibility. And perfluorocarbons are totally synthetic artificial blood products derived from fluorine and carbon containing chemicals. They're chemically inert, more effective than water or blood plasma in dissolving and absorbing oxygen in the lungs and transporting oxygen throughout the body. Another is hemoglobin based oxygen carriers, which HBOCs use the natural oxygen carrying hemoglobin to carry oxygen throughout the body. HBOCs have many potential advantages over human blood, including availability, compatibility, and long-term storage. However, they also raise a number of concerns, including toxicity. Next. A non-inflatable anti-shock garment should be made available everywhere in the rural as well as in the urban area. Next. Vacuum extraction device that does not require electricity for function, availability and use of handheld portable ultrasound machines to screen pregnant women in rural settings, and availability of well-equipped mobile emergency obstetrical care unit, which have the facility to perform cesarean section at as on their basis, wherever needed, that is obstetric kiosks. We have to have field implementation of Android app so that any communication can be possible in any emergency time. Next. Now,
I will not be doing justice if I don't tell you about obstetric transition. That is a transition of maternal mortality. Improved data related to maternal mortality reflect a changing trend from a high maternal mortality to a low maternal mortality, from direct obstetric causes to indirect obstetric causes, from less age to more age of the maternal population, from natural history to institutionalization of maternity care, and from to increasing rates of obstetric intervention and over-medicalization. Next. This brings us to the obstetric transition stage 3 in India. And why this staging is required? This staging is required for the high functioning maternal health programs because they require awareness of changing epidemiological landscape in which the primary cause of maternal health shift as the MMR declared. Next. Now, again, near miss. Near miss is a very important part because maternal mortality is just the tip of the iceberg. It has got a fast pace to the iceberg, that is maternal morbidity, which remains undescribed. But next, why we are talking of maternal near miss? And what is a maternal near miss? A woman who nearly died but survived a complication that occurred during pregnancy, childbirth, or within 42 days of termination of pregnancy. Next. Why we give importance to maternal near miss? Because near miss cases occur more often than maternal death and they generate more information because the woman herself is present there to tell you the cause of neglect, cause of delay, and cause of morbidity. Systematic identification and the study of near miss cases may provide further understanding of the determinants of maternal mortality. In developing countries, this study can be outcome measures for safe motherhood programs, and it is a very important quality indicator of maternal care. Next. Now, on the horizon of 2021, it is a very important data to share with you. The number of women who die giving birth in America each year has nearly doubled in the last two decades. The United States has higher rates of maternal deaths than 45 other countries, and it is the only developed country with a constantly rising maternal mortality rate, surpassing every other developing country in the world. In addition to the significant health disparities that exist there for Black women. Next. Now, again, the 2021, if we talk on this horizon, COVID and its effect. Recent investigations from Sweden and US have indicated that pregnant and postpartum women are at increased risk of severe complications associated with COVID-19. In an analysis of COVID-19 cases in obstetric population, the CDC reported a higher risk of ICU admission and maternal mechanical ventilation compared to non-pregnant women, although no higher risk of mortality was identified. Next. In India, the number of women who received all four antenatal checkups during the pandemic dropped by 51%. Number of institutional deliveries were down by 79%. Demand of family planning services satisfied by modern methods fell by 67% during the pandemic. These are shocking data. We have witnessed, as per Poonam Mukherjee, Executive Director of Population Foundation of India, we have witnessed a steep rise in maternal deaths during the COVID-19 pandemic. This crisis has shown us that we must strengthen health systems to cope with emergencies without impeding the essential services like maternal care. Next. Depression and attention needs to be paid to prevent and minimize negative consequences of COVID-19 for pregnant women and newborns. Government should plan to provide provisions for comprehensive maternal and child health care services along with the treatment of patients infected with SARS-CoV-2, measures to allay apprehension of getting exposed to the infection while availing care at public health facility, and even reducing the demand for routine care among the general public should be formulated at utmost exigency. Next. So to conclude, maternal health refers to the health of women during pregnancy, childbirth, and postnatal period. Maternal mortality is a key health indicator. every day in 2017, about 808 women died due to complication pregnancy and childbirth. About 295,000 women died during and following pregnancy and childbirth in 2017. Almost all of these deaths occurred in low resource settings, and most could have been prevented. The primary cause of death and of death are hemorrhage, hypertension, infection, and indirect causes, mostly due to interaction between pre-existing medical conditions and pregnancy. Next, the risk of a woman in a low-income country is 130 times higher than the risk in a developed country. Ending preventable maternal death is a top priority of the global agenda. At the same time, simply surviving pregnancy and childbirth can never be the marker of successful maternal health care. It is critical to expend efforts reducing maternal injury and disability. That means maternal morbidity has also to be reduced to promote health and well-being. Every pregnancy and birth is unique. Addressing inequalities that affect the rural and slum area women has to be taken into consideration. SDG targets aims for an average global ratio of less than 70 deaths per 100,000 births by 2030. This cannot be achieved without reproductive, maternal, and newborn child health. Next. The life of a woman is not easy. She not only has to take care of herself, but of everyone she knows. Tragedies are always in her path. It is our responsibility to give her a safe motherhood day. Wish you all a very happy, safe motherhood day. Thank you.
I think congratulations, Dr. Sangeeta. It is so much I learned today as far as the maternal mortality front are concerned. Because we are all in a private sector, and what all is happening at such a fast rate in the government sector is unbelievable. I'm told last time when you presented it, we had just missed the Millennium Development Goal targets. And now I'm told that every year there is a drop by 6 points in maternal mortality.
Yes.
In 2018, it was 113. We are already at 100 now. In today's date, in 2021. And I feel that we have still lot 10 years, and to reach the target of 70 will be doable and within the reach. But I have one thing which pains me always. If Sri Lanka at the beginning of the 21st century had the maternal mortality of 30, why we can't do it? It is just dedicated and the commitment of the medical services there for the child, for the mother.
Agreed.
So that is very important that, you know, they could do it. And I'm sure with the kind of things which are happening, we should be able to definitely do it. As far as the Scandinavian countries are concerned, not only the figures are in two digits, they are less than, they are in one digit.
Yes.
But I lost my mother when I was 6 years old.
Oh my God.
I always say, you have traveled a long distance, really long distance. And it's so heartening for me to see that the country is going down. When I met Dr. Ambarira, the health minister, in 2004, and I pleaded with Madam Renuka Chaudhary also that please tell something about him. And then finally he agreed to that no more home deliveries. And he should encourage everybody to have institutional delivery. And from that particular time, it was something like 20%, touching almost 85 to 90% delivery. So I think we have come a long way. And this is to congratulate to you, Dr. Sangeeta, again. Very shortly, in another 3 months' time, Dr. Shoma, unmute yourself. Shoma, mute yourself. In another 3 months' time, Delhi Gynecologist Forum, with the help of Department of Obstetric and Gynecology of Safdarjung, is going to start course on critical obstetrics, critical care obstetrics. It'll be paid. We'll teach you everything. When the designation, and many times our male colleagues, doctors, call gynecologist diet will change. It hurt me when I was a chairman in obstetric and gynecology in Max Hospital. One of the consultant in ICU called the gynecologist that they are no more than dyes, and it's true. They have to learn. They have to skill themselves. But it is only the story of maternal mortality which this country should remember. No development goal has been met except the maternal mortality. And I think we are going in a very right way. And this is a salute to people like Dr. Sangeeta and the people like who all are there, dedicated to the cause of maternal mortality. So with these words, anybody wants to make a very positive comment, they are open to it. Otherwise, there are no questions.
डॉक्टर ज्योति आप म्यूटेड हैं नहीं आप म्यूटेड हैं डॉक्टर ज्योति
I'm sorry about that. अपने आप ही हो जाता है My big thank you to you डॉक्टर संगीता for such a wonderful oration heartiest congratulations to you डॉक्टर संगीता
Yes डॉक्टर संगीता congratulations Truly speaking, जैसे मैम ने कहा हमें प्राइवेट सेक्टर में वी हैव वेरी यू नो हेल्दी क्लाइंटेल जो हीमोग्लोबिन 11 के साथ आती हैं और वो हमसे ज्यादा डाइट के बारे में जानती हैं वो हमसे ज्यादा पढ़कर आती हैं सो द मॉर्बिडिटी इज वेरी लेस सो वी डोंट नो सेल्फ सिनेरियो सो बट आफ्टर सुनने के बाद यू गेट टू नो दैट इज व्हाट आवर कंट्री इज मेजॉरिटी
Yeah, I know, and during this COVID time, I think at the government sector also, there has been a lot of difficulty in giving care to the patient. Patient also has difficulty to reach the healthcare facility, and we, as a facility provider and a care provider, we also are in a difficult situation, in a dilemma. Give proper care to the patient. Of course, as far as my institution is concerned, though we were a non-COVID hospital, we have given full care and full service to any patient attending the hospital. And if the patient used to turn out to be RT-PCR positive, only after the treatment which she required in an emergency, patient was shifted to any other hospital. So I think the every healthcare worker has to work hard to deal with these times and should not contribute to increase the maternal mortality.
Yes. Dr. Sangeeta, your beautiful memento and certificate will be given to you as soon as you meet physically. I'm sorry about that part.
And madam, thanks for reviving me from my coat of art. जैसे कि डॉक्टर शोभा ने कहा कि आपने याद किया तो फिर मुझे याद आया. मैडम ने मुझसे कहा संगीता यू स्टिल हैव इंटरेस्ट इन मैटरनल मॉर्टलिटी मैंने कहा मैडम दैट थिंग कैन नॉट गो अवे फ्रॉम मी एंड शी सेड शी टोल्ड मी टू टेक ड्यूरेशन एंड आई रिविजिटेड द सब्जेक्ट आई रिवाइज द सब्जेक्ट एंड इट वाज सो सैटिस्फाइंग आई कांट टेल
मैम इफ यू आर अलाइव इफ बोथ ऑफ अस आर अलाइव 10 इयर्स लेटर वी विल हैव अनदर ओरेशन बाय यू
थैंक यू लेट ऑल इंटरेस्टिंग मैम ऐसा ही हो
only on the 15th of May we have set our things from the 15-4 it has gone to 15-5 it has been confirmed those people had come today so we have shifted it on to 15-5 so that's a thing you will get your award and your certificate of delivering this oration on that particular day So congratulations to you, Dr. Sangeeta again.
Thanks, Mr. Pavan, for sharing my slides. There was some problem in directly sharing the slides from my laptop. So again, I was bothering her since quite a lot of time. But ultimately, we were made to do it. Thanks a lot, Mr. Pavan.
Thank you. Just wanted to update you about one particular point, ma'am. On the 21st of this April, ma'am, once again we are going to do a big scientific event, and that too with Dr. Sharda Jain and Dr. Narendra Malhotra. He's from Agra. So it is going to be a big webinar, and on especially on the influenza vaccination and adult immunization. It is going to be pan North India webinar. So it's a big event where both eminent speakers are going to take the session. So this is the update from my end.
Yes, my sincere request again that all of you should patronize typhoid vaccination, and the best thing is take it yourself. Let your family members take it. Your staff should take it. Then you should see how the magical effect will take place. So that is what I can have to say about the typhoid vaccination. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot to everyone for joining. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Very much.